Uganda is gearing up for its inaugural oil production in 2025, a milestone closely tied to the construction of the East African crude pipeline. Amidst this progress, the National Environment Management Authority, NEMA, recently conducted a thorough inspection of the EACOP worksites in Uganda. This feast aimed to ensure that environmental and social considerations align with the nation's eco-social goals as it moves forward with this significant project. The EACOP, stretching over 1,443 kilometers from Kabale to Hoima in western Uganda, with Uganda hosting 296 kilometers of the pipeline, is a crucial component in the country's oil production plans.
The big thing you'll see is a trench. The pipe goes into the trench, we bury the pipe, we restore the environment.
Yeah. And taking off this soil top and keeping it?
Yes, you strip the top. Then you do the trenching, you bury the pipe, and you put back the topsoil.
With the clock ticking toward the 2025 oil extraction target, Uganda is leaving no stone unturned, particularly in addressing environmental and social impacts. NEMA, as the key oversight body, took proactive steps by organizing a field visit to the Eco Project sites. The executive director of NEMA, Dr. Barirega Akankwasha, highlighted the importance of this visit, emphasizing the need for continuous monitoring to uphold environmental and social standards.
An excellent analysis of environment and social impacts of a project, you end up with a net social gain. This is a net social gain. So you've not only mitigated the social impact, but you've gone beyond. So this is a net social gain, and we expect a net biodiversity gain also, and that's the ultimate success of environment and social impact assessment.
Led by the chairman of the NEMA board, Professor James Okot Okumu, and accompanied by NEMA board members, the delegation received first-hand insights into the project's implementation from the EACOP team, represented by Deputy Managing Director John Bosco Habumugisha.
The pipeline starts from here. This is kilometer zero, and then we head to Mutukura, 296 kilometers. The Temiwentanga is 1,443. They connect here into the pump station, and then the EACOP starts its journey, as well as also feeding the refinery, which is north of this pump station site.
The NEMA delegation conducted a comprehensive examination of key sites along the EACOP route in Uganda. Stops included the main camp and pipe yards, where initial civil works were underway. Notably, the visit highlighted EACOP's commitment to corporate social responsibility, as evidenced by the Kabajo Memorial School, a project to benefit the local community.
We have a whole biodiversity offset program where we have any challenges of affecting biodiversity. We are working with the NEMA, with the National Forestry Authority, to ensure that we implement biodiversity offsets to ensure that the project achieves a net biodiversity gain.
Habumugisha provided updates on the compensation process, revealing that 3,660 individuals affected by pipeline activities have already received compensation. This underscores EACOP's dedication to fair treatment and compensation for stakeholders impacted by the project. The field visit showcased advancements in meeting social impact assessment obligations, demonstrating tangible actions toward environmental and social stewardship.
The pipes are going to be buried underground. They are not going to be on top. And that is to protect the environment.
By fostering partnerships between regulatory entities and project stakeholders, Uganda is moving towards a sustainable energy infrastructure development, prioritizing community and ecosystem welfare. As Uganda sets its sights on inaugural oil production in 2025, initiatives like the EACOP represent a significant step towards achieving national energy goals while ensuring environmental sustainability and social responsibility. Story compiled by Jimmy Luima for the news.